Okay, so the main video was talking about how neutrinos shapeshift via superposition, and a similar thing happens if you take two pendulums and attach them with a spring. On their own, they'll want to do one of two things: either swing together in the same direction, or exactly opposite each other. And when they're opposite each other, they swing slightly faster because of the help of the spring. But perhaps you interact with the pendulums and push one of them to start it swinging. When you think about it, the first pendulum swinging by itself is actually a superposition of both of them swinging the same way and both of them swinging opposite ways, combined so that the swinging of the second pendulum cancels out. However, because the same and opposite states of the pendulum don't swing with the same rate, they won't cancel out for the second pendulum forever, and eventually it will be the only one swinging, and the first pendulum will have stopped. And then later, it'll be pendulum 1, and then pendulum 2, and so on. So the states you interact with, either the left or right pendulum swinging, can oscillate back and forth between each other, swapping identities, because they're superpositions of the non-interacting states, and those states have different frequencies. Other than a few pesky details to do with quantum mechanics, this is essentially what happens with neutrinos.